Our garden has lots of perennials, and some of them I can remember the story for. For example, this Brazilian spinach, Alternanthera sisu, comes from Jeff Lawton, a permaculture teacher. This comes from some Portuguese people. This one, this cabbage that's inside these cages. And it is a perennial, it keeps going up. This celery taro we got from some Vietnamese people. You eat the stem of that. But I wanted to show you these leeks and spring onions and eschalots that we got a long time ago. So these eschalots here, these ones, are perennials. And they're a tropical kind of eschalot that Annie Jenkins sent us from North Queensland. So it's pretty unusual, or at least we'd never had them in 30 years of gardening, had French eschalots before that, you know, survive in this subtropical climate. So that's Annie Jenkins' eschalots. And then an old lady 27 years ago had these perennial leeks here in a jam tin at Fortitude Valley in Brisbane. We bought them from her. And they're special in that they never go to seed. And some of them grow big. Some of them are mediums, and they have several. And some of them bunch up, like you can see this one. It's starting to get babies. See, there's 2, 3 babies on that medium half-grown leek, whereas this one's going to be a bigger, more singular one. That one will be singular. That's a buncher. So, you know, about half of them are singular and half bunch up, and so you propagate from those sideways. And it's really easy. Like, they're always there. They survive all kinds of weed growth while we're away. And we've had them for 27 years and given away thousands of them. And then there's this other one, a spring onion, which is also a buncher. See, that one's a singular one, but this one's decided to bunch, so that's really good for propagating. You could dig that whole lot up and get about 15 from that one. The 3 funereal cockatoos. 4 and it's going to rain. But I love the perennial. Oh, look, there's a French fennel. That one, there. That came from some French relatives 32 years ago, 1980. And it self-seeds here. Oh, we should take this one out because
so you saved the seeds all along, dude.
Well, sometimes early days we did, but in recent years the soil has become our seed bank, and we just have it growing naturally. There's some there. There's some in nearly every bed of fennel, and we don't find that it's anathema to other plants. Other plants seem to quite like having fennel, despite its nasty reputation.
So is that a working site here? What's going on with the plastic around the garden, dude?
Oh, this is against the wallabies, which you can see several films about. And also this is against the wallabies because there's endive chicory and Portuguese cabbages in there.
Where is it? Can we see?
Well, probably not, because it's a bit of a fortress here. There we go. A capsicum, Portuguese cabbage. These are starting to go to seed, these chicory and endives, parsley. It's always self-sown. We never sow. Do you know, I used to have no luck with parsley, and then suddenly my luck changed when I got pregnant. And it just grows itself now. We have several hundred parsleys at any one time. Growing here, don't know why.
Looks like a mango here, doesn't it?
Well, it is a mango, and it's flowering, and it's not raining. Yay! So we will probably have mangoes this coming summer.
More Portuguese cabbage here.
Yeah, and peas. Our own 5th generation sugar snaps. These ones. Yes. A bit more water. Also protected from the wallaby. There's not many more flowers, which is a bit of a worry. Oh, there's some babies. Look, there's babies at the top. Maybe we'll get another second flowering because they've only been on for a month. Sugar snaps. Oh, they're so good. I think they're better than snow peas. Oh, look, there's a self-sown poppy there. And we haven't planted poppy in here for 10 years. Our garlic. We haven't had the garlic. We've had it only 2 years. Got it from a local person. And there's about five types of chicory. Look, there's this one here. Very kind of like, almost like dandelion. This long, dented one. And then there's that rounded one, which kind of comes from the red Treviso.
Did you save chicory. The seeds?
Well, we used to, but now the last 15 years we've let them go to seed. They have beautiful blue flowers in the mornings. And then we have these five types coming all the time, just growing, self-seeded all the time. Never have to, because the soil is a seed bank. As well as the perennials, we hardly have to plant anything. And we certainly don't have to muck around with all that transplanting and growing from seed much. You know, those peas I do.
What's that flower just on top of your head?
Oh, this is African cabbage, which we've had for 13...
What?
Yeah, it grows to 2 metres, and it's open-hearted. And you can just pick it. It's called, actually, oddly, Old Women Meet and Gossip, because it takes so long to pick, and several women could be picking it at once, I suppose, from some people from Zimbabwe. And, you know... Basically, we grow things just that work easily for us, so that's become our staple cabbage, though we've now got these Portuguese cabbages, more of them, which might also become our staples. No, we don't bother with hearting cabbages or whole onions because onions are too difficult for us, we've found. You know, there's all the sea. They suit temperate climates, but allowing them to go to seed, it's likely that there'll be a rainstorm and then there won't be any seed. So we just rely on spring onion, leeks and echalot.